Maybe 5 or 6. Which other 75 of you?
I will. It won't come to that.
All right, maybe the Brits will buckle after 20 or so. But why should you care? Because you're already dead, right? Have you thought about what you're going to be putting these boys through? I mean, putting aside what's going to happen to these poor men's families, you're going head to head with a British government who clearly despise republicanism, who are unshakable, who can easily live with the deaths of what they call terrorists. And the stakes are much higher this time.
I know that.
And if you're not even willing to negotiate, you're looking for them to capitulate. Is that it?
Right.
So failure means many dead men, families torn apart, and the whole Republican movement demoralized.
Aye. Worst case scenario, it might well mean all that. But short term, out of the ashes.
Come on.
Guaranteed there'll be a new generation of men and women. Even more resilient, more determined.
Look who you're talking to.
There's a war going on. I thought you might understand. You're talking like a foreigner.
You're talking to me like I'm a foreigner. You think I don't know Northern Ireland? I live here, man.
Then support us.
I supported the first hunger strike on the basis it was a protest. Not some pre-designed to die and balk at negotiation other than complete surrender from Thatcher. That's ridiculous, Bobby. It's destructive.
What's happening here for the last 4 years? The brutality, humiliation, our basic human rights taken away from us. All of this has to come to an end.
Through talking.
So what? We take their offer and put their uniform on because the last 4 years have meant nothing. We could do that, though. Or we could behave like the army we proclaim to be and lay down our lives for our comrades.
Is there not even a small part of you that's hoping for a breakthrough that could find you negotiating again?
That won't happen.
Right, forget about that. I want to know whether your intent is just purely to commit suicide here.
You want me to argue about the morality of what I'm about to do and whether it's really suicide or not? For one, you're calling it suicide. I call it murder. And that's just another wee difference between us two. We're both Catholic men, both Republicans. But while you were poaching salmon in lovely Kilray, we were being burnt out of our house in Rathcoole.
Right.
Similar in many ways, Dom, but life and experience has focused our beliefs differently. You understand me?
I understand.
I have my belief. And in all its simplicity, that is the most powerful thing.
So what's your statement by dying? Just highlighting British intransigence? So fucking what? The whole world knows what the Brits are like.
Good.
Aye, it is good. And it's nothing to do with you. The Brits have been fucking up everything for centuries.
I can feel your hatred, Dom.
Oh, you looking for martyrdom?
No.
You sure?
Aye.
Because I've heard you eulogising Wolfe Tone, Connolly, McSwinney, all them men. Can't help thinking you're writing your name large for all them history books.
Because you think that matters to me.
Oh, aye. I know it does.
Well, you're wrong.
You see, you soldiers, it's all about the freedom. But you got no appreciation of a life, Bobby. You no longer know what a life is, you man. 4 years living in these conditions, no one expects you to be normal. There's nothing normal about you. Right now, the Republican movement has talked itself into a corner. You IRA are standing right behind it looking into that corner. All that history, all them dead men and women, you're still seeing nothing. When your answer is to kill everything, you've blinded yourself and you're scared to stop it. Afraid of living. Afraid of talk and peace. So what would Ulster be if it wasn't turning itself to shit? And this situation here, that the future of the Republican movement is in the hands of you men who have lost all sense of reality. You think your head's on right? Locked up in here 24 hours a day and piss and shit. And you are making decisions that could see so many men die. Build a statue to Bobby Sands. You're joking me. Freedom fighter. They're the men and women working out there in the community. And that was you once upon a time, am I right? All that work you did in Twinbrook. That's where we need you, Bobby, and you know I'm right.
But I'm deluded. You want me to answer that?
They're beating you, Bobby. You're playing into their hands.
The strategy's in place.
Then stop it. Just say stop.
You don't understand a thing.
You're in no shape to make this call.
It's done. It won't be stopped.
Then fuck it. Life must mean nothing to you.
God's gonna punish me.
Well, if not just for the suicide, then he'd have to punish you for stupidity.
Aye. And you for your arrogance. Because my life is a real life, not some theological exercise, some religious trick that's got fuck all to do with living. Jesus Christ had a backbone. But see them disciples, every disciple since, you're just jumping in and out of the rhetoric and dead-end semantics. You need the revolutionary. You need the cultural political soldier to give life a pulse, to give life a direction.
That's stupid talk. You're deluded.
Aye. So you say.
Yeah, and what's your wee son gonna say?
Fuck off.
Doesn't that interest you?
You're gonna attack me with sentiment. Typical priest.
What's your heart saying, Bobby?
I thought you'd be all figured out, Dom.
What's it saying? Tell me.
My life means everything to me. Freedom means everything. I know you don't mean to mock me, Dom, so I just let all that pass. This is one of these times when we've come to a pause. It's a time to keep your beliefs pure. I believe that a united Ireland is right and just. Maybe it's impossible for a man like you to understand. But having a respect for my life, a desire for freedom, an unyielding love for that belief, means I can see past any doubts I may have. Putting my life on the line is not just the only thing I can do, Dom. It's the right thing.
This is why you called me here. You need a sounding board. Not 100% sure of yourself. Been doubting yourself, maybe.
Aye. We're only human.
And I've made it clear for you then.
Man of guidance, Dom. Business of the soul. You've been to Gweedore in Donegal?
Aye.
I went there when I was 12. Big cross-country race for the boys, and we're all in the back of a minibus headed towards Derry one morning. I mean, this is big time. You know, this is like international athletics for us, because we're racing against boys in the south, and we have this thing to do Belfast Pride. Two of the boys are prods, the rest of us are Catholics. It's a cross-community event. I suppose the good people in the south think this is great stuff, and let's get this wee team over from Belfast and all that patronising shite. Anyway, we're through the border. The boys are all singing pop tunes and all, but I'm just on the back of the bus looking out the window. We're going through them mountains. You know where Mount Errigal is and everything? It's a beautiful sight, Dom. Donegal has to be the most beautiful place in Ireland, I reckon.
Aye.
Anyway, we arrive at Gweedore. What a place, and it's hopping with about 200 boys in there, getting into their gear and limbering up. The whole event's run by Christian Brothers, and they're clipping young fellas around the back of the ears, basically trying to retain some order. Our team goes off for a wee jog, stretch out the legs. We're surrounded by fields of barley. And they dip down into a wee valley where there's a stream and woods running through it. Woods and the stream are out of bounds, so naturally us Belfast boys have to go check them out. Woods in a stream, Dom, sure, that's like the Amazon to us. And we come across these young fellas from Cork. There's some banter about our accents, but they could barely talk. We couldn't understand what they were saying. You get the idea that they're lording it over us a bit, you know? Looking down on us. I'm sensing it anyway. We're running along, and we come up with this idea to go down to the stream and check it out for fish. So we're down by the river, Dom, stream. There's half a foot of water in there. Little silver fish, but none substantial. Till one of their boys calls us further down. Lying in the water is a wee foal. 4 or 5 days old. He's all skin and bone, a grey colour. and he's got flecks of blood in his coat.